Today is Wednesday, June 30th, and this is The Daily, a daily dose of scripture to help you meditate on the theme of the week from the past Sunday's sermon. We address the question, does God really forgive everyone this last week? Now, the third form taken by forgiveness centers on the relationship between two human creatures who have become sadly linked through some sin of one kind or another. This is the forgiveness that is communicated by person B to person A when person A comes to him and seeks forgiveness for the sin committed against person B. Clearly, if person B has already fully embraced the second sort of forgiveness that we talked about yesterday and has chosen an attitude and posture that trusts God and so lets go of the wrong done to him by person A, actually communicating that forgiveness to his repentant fellow creature, his fellow human neighbor, will not be difficult. Indeed, it's a joyful proclamation and delight that person A has come to see his own sin and even has sought forgiveness that may lead to reconciliation. Though within human relationships, such reconciliation rarely means a simple return to the status quo before the sin occurred, as if it had never been done. Seeking to work through the hurts experienced and the damage done to the relationship in appropriate ways is not indicative of a failure to forgive, but rather a reality of healthy and growing relationships founded on trust and reliance in God's grace. This third kind of forgiveness occurs only after the one who committed the sin has arrived at the point of repentance and actually seeks forgiveness from the one he hurt with his sin. This aspect of forgiveness plays out within the horizontal plane of relationships between two human beings. Jacob's repentance and Esau's forgiveness in Genesis 33 verses 1 through 4 help depict this third part of forgiveness. And Jacob lifted up his eyes and looked, and behold, Esau was coming, and 400 men with him. So he divided the children among Leah and Rachel and the two female servants. And he put the servants with their children in front, then Leah with her children, and Rachel and Joseph last of all. He himself went on before them, bowing himself to the ground 7 times, until he came near to his brother. But Esau ran to meet him and embraced him and fell on his neck and kissed him, and they wept. Reconciliation. You are forgiven, friends. Now forgive others as Christ forgave you.